This is a video that I've been a little bit intimidated to make for quite a long time. It's a kit build of, I'll get into that in a minute. So because it's, I'm a little bit nervous about this, I'm just going with a nice familiar beer, Oxus's Juice of the Oats Oatmeal Stout. I've had this one before, it's very nice. So, the reason that this intimidated me is because of, it's got some mechanical things to pay attention to, not just electronics and soldering and stuff. It is the IC station 4x4x4 LED cube. As you can tell by the shape of the board, it is designed to act as a shield that stacks on top of an Arduino Uno, just like that. But we'll get to that in a bit. So that's the first part of it. So the brains of the operation is the Arduino itself. It's got a couple of shift registers on it, some current limiting resistors, some pins, and then a whole shitload of LEDs. These are the cute little out-of-focus rectangular LEDs. I mean, you could use any LED really, but and these are nice blue, which is kind of cool. Now, the intimidating part of this is the mechanical structure, because I have to build a three-dimensional sculpture, essentially, out of these LEDs. There's four layers, each one having 4x4, so 16 16 16 16. But I think I'm going to do the easy part first. I'm going to solder up this board first. Let's go and take a quick peek at the kit, just so that you're a little bit familiar with it and stuff. So, as I said, this is the IC station 4x4x4 LED cube kit for Arduino Uno. You could get it off IC Station for $5.99. I got it from eBay probably over a year ago, actually. So there's a little bit of information here, just showing the nodes, not the actual schematic. Because here's the connections to the anode side of the LEDs. Here's the cathode connections through the resistors. There's the connections to the Arduino. And here is the two shift registers. But again, it's not showing a lot of what's going on there. I guess I should go into this shift register just a little bit too. So it is an 8-bit serial input or serial parallel output shift register with tri-state outputs. Tri-state being the outputs can either be high or low or floating, not connected to anything. And here it is basically. So there's pin 14 serial data comes in, and pin 11 there's clocks. Every time the clock does a ka-chunk-a-chunk, it reads one bit of serial data. There's a reset, there's a latch, and there's an output enable. And then there's a serial data out. So I'm guessing that serial data out is connected to the first chip is connected to the serial data in of the second chip. And the clock and latch, the clock and latch are probably tied together so that it shifts 16 bits from the Arduino. I'm guessing here, but this makes sense to me. It'll shift 16 bits in, so the first 8 will pass through this one and out to the second one, and then the second 8 bits will land in this one. Then it'll latch it and output enable it, which will toggle from whatever the previous state on this thing was to the new data. The other really useful thing on this IC Station webpage is this download link, which I didn't know, I wasn't aware of when I bought the kit, and it wasn't until I went looking for this on its home page here that I found it. But in that download link, we get a zip file, which contains another zip file. It contains a welding guide, aka soldering guide, which is gonna come in really handy. So it suggests to build the circuit board first, starting with populating these header pins, then put in 4 resistors, and then the IC sockets. And that's basically the board done. Then it says to build this little jig, I guess is what it really is, on a piece of perf board with some male header pins, some dual male header pins. They didn't send any of these small ones with or the normal length ones with the kit, so I'll just have to break out some from my collection, which of course I have. Now comes the fun part. Okay, so basically the longer pin, which is the anode, the positive, goes straight like this, and it wants you to bend the cathode at 90 degrees on all of them. And then they all lay out like that. And then the whole thing just plugs in there. So again, that's all the anodes going straight down into these female header pins that we put in earlier. And then the negatives, you can see they've got them sort of labeled there. So you connect each of the layers. So all of the cathodes of each of the four layers are all together. Ah, and then it shows here, you take the top layer's cathode and it goes down to that pin there. I can't read what it says. And the second layer from the top to this one, and then the third layer in the bottom layer to this one in this corner. Okay, so I got everything set up over here, I think, to start with the header pins on the board. I just have to snap them off one at a time, I suppose. Now, the header pins that it showed didn't have the plastic shrouding on them, so I'm not sure if I can take that off easily. I'll give it a shot. I don't think it matters, though. No, I don't think it matters. Just maybe it looks cooler that way. Oh, these things are going to fall out. Which means I'm going to be fully blue tack mode here. That's going to slow me down some. But so it goes. And I'm not sure if I'm going to need any flux with this or not. This is a very good quality solder. It's MG chemical stuff. It's not the cheap chinesium that I have had before, but we'll try it. That seemed to take fairly well. That's nice, although I do have my flux just handy over there, just in case. And that's fairly straight. Yeah, I think that'll work. Okay, I'm going to set up a bunch of these then and just solder them in. Actually, as I've been snapping these off, I've noticed that if I snip them this way, I can get the insulation off them, and some of them are actually just coming off anyway, so I'm going to do that too. Ah, that's why it wouldn't pull off. There's little ridges, there's little circular ridges around there. Okay, we'll carry on with this project. Okay, that's almost all the header pins in place except for these two, and I'm going to shift the board over after I solder the rest of these. So, here we go, soldering mode. Okay. I'll remove all that blue tack, shift the board over and do those ones. All right. That is all those female header pins in. So the resistors, four 500 ohm resistors there. I'm going to trust that they sent me the right resistors for the kit. It's not a big deal to change them out if they didn't, but it should be right. And those are the current limiting resistors that go on the cathode side of the LEDs. Yeah, since there's only four cathode lines come down off the cube, and all the rest of them are anodes, it's easier to just do it with four resistors rather than 16. Like I said at the beginning, this is the easy part of the kit. This is something that doesn't bother me at all, and it'll sort of build my confidence up enough that I can get overconfident and screw up royally when I get into the upper part. So next in is the IC sockets. Two IC sockets, and they just drop in there, notch end there, notch end there, and oh, hang on, I gotta fix that resistor first. That's ugly as hell. That's more better. I'll solder that up a little bit cleaner when I get on the other side again. Okay, that looks pretty good. Trim off those wayward resistors. Okay, sockets are in place. Let's see what's next. So for some reason, it doesn't show it on the soldering instructions, but I'm going to put the long header pins on that go down to the between the Arduino and the shield next. And it doesn't make use of all of the pins, so it was a little bit weird to figure it out over on this side where the analog and the power and stuff is. But it doesn't even have holes for the reference and the reset pin, so I had to cut that one down to match. But now it just drops on there like that. Right, more soldering. Yeah, that'll do. Oh, missed one. There. I'll just give that a quick cleaning. I'll be right back. Okay, I spared you the pain of watching me put this little thing together, but I just took a chunk of perf board, cut it off to the approximate size, and put the header pins in there in a 2-centimeter grid, like it says. So next thing is to start is bending up these LEDs. Should I test them before I put them in? Yeah, probably. Just to make sure. And the last one. Yep, they're all good. I guess I shouldn't really have expected there to be bad ones, but like I said, you don't want to get halfway through this thing and then run into it. So the drawing showed leaving the anode along and bending the cathode off to the side. So anode down, cathode up, bend it 90 degrees. So on these LEDs, you know, there's always that little pinch point from manufacturing on there, so I'm going to use that as my marker to make the bend. I'm going to try and do it consistently across all of them, so like that, and 90 degrees to the left, like that ish and then plonk them into here somehow. There we go. Something like that. A whole bunch of times. So this isn't as scary as I'd initially thought it was going to be. It's just going to be monotonous as hell. Yeah, that's looking more like it's going to work. Okay. The bending continues. So now comes the interesting part, trying to solder this all together. I've got some solder on it. Nudge it into place. Okay, that's not bad. Each one's going to take a little bit of frittery adjustment here, I'm afraid. Yeah, now then, these anodes. That first one should be, you know, that first couple I think I can get at, and they don't look like they're shorting. Let's see if I can get in there. Did that take? It did. This one can actually be pushed down a little bit, I think. Ah, it's not shorting. I think I'll display this in a dark room so that the sins of my soldering are hidden in the shadows cast by the glorious blue LEDs. This is kind of frittery, but it's also sort of relaxing in a weird kind of a way. I think I've done it. Now then, let's see if I can get it out of this jig without destroying it too badly. Oh, that didn't take back there. Okay. Back down you go. I was afraid that might happen in some parts here. Ooh, ooh. There we go. We have an grid. Okay. Can I test this before I go any further? Let's just do it from out here. Okay. That works. That works. Nice. Okay, one down, three more to go. The astute among you may have noticed that I was so eager to get that first one done that I forgot to do the fourth row. So here is the second one with the fourth row in place. I'm gonna have to revisit this guy in a minute, but yeah, as I'm sure somebody's gonna notice. I'm sure lots of people are going to notice, actually. You guys seem to be paying more attention to what I'm doing than I am sometimes. Which is cool. It keeps me honest. Anyway, I'm going to get to soldering this one, and I'll be back. And there's the fourth one soldered up and tested with minimal issues. The fourth one took a lot less time than the previous ones. I guess that shouldn't be a surprise. Now, per the instructions, we'll plug these into the header pin, the sockets here. These will turn to pin sockets. This is a good trick, trying to get them all lined up. Okay, there it's all in. Get these guys a little bit more parallel. The next thing, according to the instructions, is to join the row or the layers together. It means bending these guys over and soldering them that way. And that will help to keep the layers all, or the columns all lined up too, once that's soldered down. I wonder if I need to bend these ones back this way too. That might make it easier at the end, I'm not sure. And now the soldering commences. Trying to keep it all sort of parallel and everything else. I think I'm just gonna have to get a big blob in there. I don't know, I may have to tweak this later. Oh, this is, and it's a little bit frittery, but it's coming together. And with every layer that I get soldered up, it becomes a bit more rigid. Just a matter of keep on messing with it until it all goes. So I think I've got all the columns soldered up and all the layers soldered together. So now I just need to go from each layer down to these four pins here. And forgetting from the layers down to these pins, there wasn't any wire included in the kit for that. So I'm going to use bits of Cat 5 if they will stick properly into these pins, these headers. Yes, they will. Okay. And trim that off just up a little bit there. Now then, I need to straighten that out a bit. I know in the kit, in the instructions sheet, it shows this as just going off at a funky angle, but I'm not sure that I want to do that. I think if I can just come in, bend in the back of there so that it hooks on, get on there. There, I think that's gonna go if I can just hold that long enough. No. Need to get some more solder in there is what it is. There we go. Ow. Yeah, that's not the most artistic. I might trim that later. Or actually, hang on here. Maybe I'll just make it go like that. So that's the top one. Next one is that layer. Next one is that layer. Next one is the bottom layer. So just for reference, there's the shape of the pieces that I'm using. This length here just gets longer, shorter as they go in here. And there's the last one in. So that should be complete except for dropping the two chips in and testing it out. Suppose I could have put the chips in before, but I always like to leave them till absolutely all the soldering is done. I was planning on showing you putting the chips in, however my SD card decided not to cooperate. So we'll just have to carry on, and I'm going to have to record some more video, or re-record some video, which you'll see later. But meanwhile, let's go and put some software onto this thing. So in that zip file, or RAR file, I guess, that I downloaded, there is this Arduino zip folder. In it is a folder called Arduino, and in that is a directory called IC Station Light Cube. That drops into your Arduino libraries folder, right into there. Arduino/libraries might be slightly different layout on Windows or Mac, but that's where it exists on Linux. And there it is there. Inside that is the header files and all that good stuff that you need, and also examples. So when you launch your Arduino IDE, go into examples and scroll down. There's IC Station Light Cube, and there is Special Effects Sketch. Not much to it, because that hex file there, that header file, does most of it. So this is just an example. But we'll upload that and see what it does. Now we have finished functional hardware, or hopefully functional anyway, and we have software loaded onto this guy. So let's power it up and see what happens. And just for the ultimate light show, I'm going to dim the lighting here just a little bit. Actually, a lot. All right, ready? Here we go. Woohoo! Blinking lights! And columns and rows, and it's brightest from straight up, but you can see it from all over the place. Well, that's fun. I guess the next challenge for me is going to be coming up with some other code, or getting my pet code monkey to do it for me, to get some other code into this thing to do other patterns and stuff, just not just the stock one that came for with the test. But that's okay. We'll live with this for now. I'm gonna call that a win. I think this thing was my lifesaver, because I don't know how else I would have got all those LEDs lined up. Another option that I was thinking of was using a grid like this and poking them in, but then I just couldn't figure out exactly how to do the bends and connect the layers and stuff, because that way I would have been building each layer rather than each vertical slice. I don't know. I might save this and try it again with 3mm round LEDs, because of course this is all just plugged in, right? So I can do anything I want. All right, well, thanks for watching. I appreciate that as always. Questions, comments, complaints, laughter at my various screw-ups, down in the comments section as usual. Thanks again for watching, and I will talk to you later. Yes, it's empty. Let's just pretend it's really weird.